You ever spent an hour trying to get AI to design something usable, only to end up fixing wrapped texts or scrapping the whole thing? Yeah, same here. But today, Ideogram dropped the biggest update yet. Version 3.0 promises clearer text, better control, and way more style options. So the real question is, did AI finally get it right for designers like us? If you're in the print-on-demand game, or designing products, this update can seriously change your workflow. Imagine making standout, niche-ready designs without bouncing between the 5 tools or spending hours tweaking stuff that AI should have nailed the first time. I've tested every update from Ideogram since day one, and today I'm breaking down exactly what's new, what's better, and whether 3.0 is worth your time. Let's dive in. Ideogram 3.0 just came out, right? Now, I watched this whole video over here on their YouTube channel. I'm gonna link it down below in the description, but one of the cool things that I've recognized is obviously like the reference, okay? And then just it's just a better tool. They made it so much better, the reference part of it. Let me check this out real fast. Let me show you the consistent style. So the style reference, which they share right here. I like that. And the little, there's more and more. You can go ahead and watch that video. But as far as print-on-demand sellers and t-shirt designers and understanding the whole process, that right there, I was taking that into conception and thinking of an idea of how to create this video. What can I do to provide value as far as, like, how is it going to help you with your business? And that's the main goal, why I'm creating this video. So I was like, you know what? I got an idea. This is really good. So let's go ahead and let's break it down. We'll see what we're going to do right here. All right. So if you don't have Ideogram, you have to sign up for it to use this new 3.0 model. You're gonna see 3.0, our most advanced model, 2.0, 2A, and 1.0. So let's come over here first and foremost that we're gonna do research. I did research over here on, I'll put this link down below in the description too as well, Amazon Hot New Releases. Came over here and did research. You're gonna see the Gulf of America, and we have some trending designs over here. I always like to look at this because it helps us. I'm looking for a niche or design that's selling consistently to show us that there's obviously a demand in this niche and we can make sales if we create something like in the niche or something similar to the actual design, or even if you just come up with inspiration yourself, right? So this right here, everyone is welcome here. I like this concept right here. I think it's really cool, but let me show you how we're gonna go ahead and use this. And I'm gonna show you a few different ways, okay? So as far as like creating the actual original or creating an actual original design, we're gonna come on here to ChatGPT. I'm gonna put, give me 5 design ideas that are similar to this. Send ChatGPT, there's a free version of it too, so don't think everything in this, you know, you have to pay for it. This is more of give you an idea of how you can leverage this for your business. Now, one thing I love to use over here, let it shoot that information for us. One thing I love to use inside of Ideogram, let me go ahead and switch this to the 4-5. Magic prop auto style, just auto. And then you can obviously change your color palette right there if you wanted to, which is really cool too. Or you can add your custom one. We're gonna go ahead and copy and paste that. One thing I love to do is, so if you see like an idea, this is how you come up with like original concepts too as well. You can hit describe and it will describe the actual whole design for you. But let's say like we want to style reference, we're going to hit the style reference. But what we're going to go ahead and do, use that as a style, use that as a reference of it. We have the inspiration of the design, but we're going to create something different. Okay. All right. So it went ahead and ChatGPT gave us 5 different ideas. Okay, then these are some really good ones, right? And that concept is, it's like, I don't want to create a design that everyone else is creating. We know that it's trending. We know it's making a lot of sales. We know that it's made its first sale about 9 days ago. But look at that. The thing's crushing, right? Making a lot of sales. So when I see something like that, I'm just like, all right, cool. This is really cool. This is nice. It's understand the idea behind it. I like it. I love it. It's cool design, t-shirt design. But I don't want to do what everyone else is doing. I want to create my own. So like, I feel like this one right here, I love unites us all. I like this right here. So now what we're gonna do is use this right here, this number 2 reference right here, and then we're gonna go back into Ideogram AI, okay? Now, keep in mind, so it has that style reference right here. So you love unites us all with different colored hands. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit generate. And as we hit that, it's going to go ahead and create the prompt or the design for us. Now, one thing I realize when you're using this right here, you just want to keep in mind, you want to just keep it short. So it understands when you put like the parentheses, okay, and then I just put different colored hands. You can adjust this how you want it to be, but it's grabbing the style from here, which is really cool. Okay, so let's go ahead and bring this up. You can see it's grabbing the style from the actual text we put in. It's very simple. Okay, so if you're messing with this and you're trying to come up with different inspiration or different ideas, this is one way. See, love unites us all, which is pretty cool. We got hands all, and it got the hands all pretty good, right? And it has little hearts in the middle. Okay, and the text wrong there. This one right here, love unites us all, pretty cool. Love unites us all, right here, pretty cool. But you see the idea, you see the concept, and just leveraging that little feature, it's making it easier for the actual AI generator to understand what you're talking about, okay? So you don't have to write this big prompt, this huge prompt, and put it in there to describe exactly what you want. But it's not saying that giving it more information is not good. Giving it, obviously, more information and more detail is always good, right? Especially with these AIs, because you're trying to help them understand what you're talking about. And one cool thing too is, like, when you click on this, you can have it, you can upscale it, you can remix it, describe, you can even use this one as the style reference if you wanted to. Okay, say that you like this one and you don't like the example that we find, that we found over here on Amazon. But you can see the concept, see the idea, see the hearts on the hands. Okay, everyone is welcome here. And then we come over here in the ideogram, we went ahead and came up with a different idea by using ChatGPT to come up with something that's similar, but not just copying in from this actual design itself. And if you come down here, you're going to see there's a few other ones that I've created, right? Pretty cool. And if you look at this one, look, the only thing I put in this prompt was love unites us all, and look what it created by using the style reference. Okay, didn't have the hands in there, that was the only thing, but I just added with different colored hands and added in the previous one I shared with you. But this one right here, I just love unites us all, to see what it could come up with. And it actually just, it came up with that rainbow style, just all the different colors, the colorfulness in the actual design itself. And there's this one, I actually did it with the hands in there by relating to that actual reference that I uploaded over here. I just used simple, just text based right there. So I wanted to see if it would get it in it. It seemed like it got the actual reference from this one. All right, now, so I got this little bunny face. Okay, I was doing a little bit of research and I found it over here in the same spot right here, the new releases, right? We're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna grab this image and we're gonna have a little bit of fun with this, right? Bringing it into Ideogram. Style reference again, cool rabbit with hoodie on and sunglasses. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and hit generate. It's pretty good. Okay, let's say standing sideways. And you can see, like, just getting the idea and then getting the concept. Oh, this is good, I like it. I like this one a lot right here. This is the one. All right, so you see how we're like, it's dropping down in layers, and then we're looking at, we literally have 8 images like that. And this one has a little bit of color too, okay? And keep in mind too, you can change the color. Like, now I'm just like, but look at this, dang, look at this, has the zip. This is clean, right? This is a clean one. Now, we can go ahead and open it up in Canvas. And keep in mind, like, this, like, the concept and the idea, you can literally just start creating a whole storybook right here. Okay, but I said, like, you want to add some text over this, okay? Or even just add, like, I'm thinking just like a background with like graffiti wall, something like that. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is go ahead and leverage the extend and maybe even the magic fill. I think this will be really good too as well. And then put right here, I'm about that, and then put rabbit life or bunny life. Let's just put rabbit life. Pretty, it's clean like that too. Maybe erase that little period right there. And then basically the concept and the idea were just like coming up off of this coming off of like the inspiration from here, and then I went ahead and he put it all together and created my own, right? So just understanding the process, it does take a little bit of brain power, but leveraging like Ideogram, and then you can see how I put it together and it like gathers all the information. I think it looks pretty clean like that. But now let's say like the magic feel, like trying to see what we can add, like maybe something here in the background. I'm thinking like a skateboard or maybe some headphones on the ground, bitten like a little carrot or something. A carrot, a bite out of a carrot. And let's see what it does. It did, I got the carrot, but we're missing the bite. Come on, but that's still pretty clean.
All right, so I'm actually liking the image exactly like this. I think it's really cool. Okay, so yeah, so you can go ahead and if you wanted to, you can go ahead and upscale the image or even remove the background, okay, or even download the PNG. So let's go ahead and download that PNG so you can see. So I downloaded the PNG. All right, so I'm about that rabbit life. You can see exactly what we created. We got the inspiration from this actual design and went over here and created our own. That's pretty clean, right? Even the carrot, how we added it into there. I didn't make the bite out of the carrot, but I'm actually happy with that carrot. It's pretty cool. I'm about that rabbit life.
All right, now, so I did the same exact prompt in the 2.0. Okay, so you can go ahead and switch the models right here. I switched it, and remember, we're using the 3.0, the most advanced model, and love unites us all with different colored hands. You can see it generated this over here. So let's go ahead and pull it up. Right now, when you compare, you look at this one's not too bad. I'm feeling like the 3.0 is under what I'm feeling right now is it feels like the 3.0 understands you a bit more. Okay, so it's more like understanding, which is really good because it's the most advanced model. And we can go ahead and let's go ahead and test. It actually did the magic prompt with that one too. So let's go ahead and let's generate another one and see exactly how it comes out, just to give you an idea. And this is the, so this is the 3.0, okay? So remember, this one is the 3.0 that we use right here. So it's doing more of like realistic hands, okay, in this one compared to the other one. I feel like I said, love unites all. This one's not bad. This one's not bad. But comparing like the 3.0 and the 2.0, you can see, I feel like that, go back over here, like looking at some of these other ones we've done, you can see that it understands, like looking at the reference, it's reading it and getting a better feel for it. This is the 3.0, right? You're showing the model. You can see the model number right there too as well. It'll tell you the model on all that information. Love unites us all. Okay. And let's say, let's go click on this one. You can see it's made with the 2.0. So just to give you an idea, when you compare the two, and you be the judge, I feel like it's still like the 2.0 still creates decent designs, right? But I feel like the 3.0 is just a notch up and it makes the designs better. But the cool thing about this, by the way, is that we have access to it all, right? If you're signed up with Ideogram AI, we have access to 1.0, 2A, 2.0, 3.0. This is the cool thing. So if you like the 2.0 model better than the 2A, or if you like the 2.0 better than the 1.0, like you can use it. Or if you like the 3.0 better than the 2.0, there it is. It's right there at your fingertips. So I think just comparing them, this is my personal opinion. I think that definitely the 3.0 is really cool and worth it as far as the new upgrade and it understanding everything. And obviously we just use simple text-based, like a simple text-based prompt. You can definitely do more with the prompt and test it out even more. But I feel like this is a really good at understanding you. And when you're putting in something simple, it gets you, it understands you, it gets you. If you haven't tried Ideogram 3.0 yet, go check it out. It's fast, and honestly, it might become your new favorite design tool. If you're already using it, drop your best prompt in the comments. I want to see what you're making. And if you found this breakdown helpful, give it a maybe share it with a fellow designer, and definitely hit that subscribe button if you want more AI content like this. I got more creative tools and time-saving workflows coming soon, so stay tuned and watch this AI video next right here.